is that growing brings the fear in death in itself. The stench of death, holding on to the coffin. I remember in one of the brethren funeral in San Fernando, he was a young man there, very strong, big, big man in his early 20s, and his grandfather died. And that young man held on to that coffin, and he would not let go. Death robbed him of that, and he held on. They took about three big men to get him loose, and they still could not. His brother had to talk to him, and then consciousness. Then you realize you have to let go. Death separates. My dear friend, death, the Grim Reaper, it will destroy. It's appointed unto man once to die, and after that, the judgment. Do not die in your sins. It's not an easy thing. It's not an easy thing. And the thing about what frightens man about death again is the unknown. Where are you going? Where are you going? If you should die now, where are you going? There is a heaven to gain and a hell to shun. Where are you going? Have you made your reservation for heaven? Are you born again? And by not being born again, my dear friend, fear comes into your heart, because what awaits you is hell and damnation. You're afraid. You don't know where you're going. And that's what brings a fear about death. You don't know what will happen. You don't know what will happen. Uncertainty in death and the judgment that is after death. You know you have to face God sometime. And what you're doing, you know you're not doing it right. Something is wrong. You're living a wrong life. Your life is not in tune. You have not yet made a decision for Jesus. And you have to face God. What will you tell him? The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. My dear friend, it's important. It's important. We want you to know this. Just recently, we heard about what happened in France. Still on the news, 168 people ushered into eternity and still counting. They say there's more than that. Just recently, my dear friend, death may strike at any moment. The uncertainty of death, that's why people are very much afraid. Unexpectedness, as I would like to say. You're in the bleak and the strength of your youth, and death should knock at your door. What would you do? As I shared with you the last time about the man who was living in the penthouse, and he was up there, the one was living downstairs, and death came to the man upstairs, and he said, "Oh boy, come back next week, death. Come back next week and I'll go with you." And what he did, he went and exchanged the room upstairs for downstairs. And the man downstairs went upstairs. So when death come, death knocked at the door. He said, "Boy, I think those stairs too high, the crime, I'll take the man downstairs." And that was the man. That was the man. My dear friend, when God calls, you have to respond. It's appointed unto man once to die, and after death, the judgment. Death and hell was cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. As we have been hearing this morning, the books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the book of life, and whose name was not found written in the Lamb's book of life, was cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. For a child of God, you are born twice and die once. For a person out of Christ, you are born once and die twice. The second death will catch you into the lake of fire. For the child of God, we are born physically and then we are born again spiritually. Hallelujah! And we will die physically like all, but death and hell was cast into the lake of fire. So even at death, you're going to experience the lake of fire. So therefore, my dear friend, we are telling you, it's important. It's important to make a decision for Jesus right now. It is important to say, "Yes, Lord, come into my heart and save me. Repent of your sin. Believe that Jesus Christ died and rose again from the dead, and salvation will be yours. Salvation will be yours." Jesus said, "I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also." If you're not in Christ, you will not be able to go to that prepared place for a prepared people. So my dear friend, as we hear this lesson, I want you to think very seriously. It's appointed unto man once to die, and after death, the judgment. If you're in Christ, we can say, absent from this body, present to be with the Lord. Hallelujah, amen? Present to be with the Lord. So make your calling and election sure. Right now, you can bow your hearts, or bow your hearts, bow your head, and say, Lord, forgive me. Come into my heart and save me. Make me a child of thine. And God is going to do it. Repent of your sin and ask him to save you. Ask him to save you. Let's just bow our heads, close our eyes in prayer. And while you are praying, and God is speaking to you, and you're not yet saved, you can rise to your feet. Don't be afraid. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up for Jesus. Make that decision before it is too late. God is willing to hear you, my dear friend. We do not want you to end up into a lost eternity. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and salvation is yours. Let's pray. Father and God, we are again thankful for your good. And as I will begin to saturate the hearts of individuals within the sound of our voices, we pray, Lord, that many conviction will come to fruition, to the point where that they can say, yes, Lord, come into my heart and save me. We are praying, Lord, that they will see Christ and call him blessed before it is too late. Believe that Jesus Christ died and rose again from the dead, and salvation will be theirs. Bless us, Lord, as we patiently upon thee. We think of our relatives. We have relatives who are not yet saved, but we pray for them. We would not want to see them end up into a lost eternity. And we pray, Lord, that you will touch their hearts. Touch their hearts. Bring them to know you, whom to know is life eternal. Bless us, O God. Bless us, O God. We do pray. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen.